Hi, thank you so much for being with us. Can you tell us about yourself and your expertise?
Hi, yes, thank you for having me. My name is Anais. Roque. I am a researcher at ASU. I am from Puerto Rico, and my expertise includes water insecurity in the aftermath of hurricanes. This is all very driven by my experiences as a shelter administrator during Hurricane Maria in Puerto Rico and how to best support underserved communities in terms of water insecurity.
Thank you. Can you explain for us how communities use water sharing to respond to water scarcity in disasters like hurricanes and earthquakes?
Yes, so water sharing strategies are usually mostly used as a coping mechanism. So they're very reactive, mostly without planning. They're based on reciprocity and solidarity due to the worry that occurs after an extreme weather event where there's lack of state assistance. And they're a big, really big solution that is constantly being ignored because it's mostly on people and government officials or any other officials are not involved in these dynamics. So water sharing constantly becomes as the main area where these communities can use it to secure water.
So this is mainly a coping strategy that communities are organizing themselves. How can water managers support community-based water sharing as a disaster response?
Well, they can do it in various ways. So for example, they can do it by collaborating with community leaders, emergency managers, and other relevant actors in the areas of developing household strategies in times of need. For example, plans on how much water the household will need, if there's ways of where they're gonna get it from, how are they gonna like prepare for the future, connecting residents with alternative water sources, and also like supporting the network development for those in the margins. So for example, women, older folks, and children, and especially considering context and place-based needs. So for example, in my experiences in Puerto Rico, I've seen that there's a need, for example, that a community has water, but they wanna give water to another community, right? And the water managers of the sites want to secure water just for them. So really trying to understand the local needs and what are the people's wants to share water and trying to basically like strategize in ways that both their understandings as experts in the area align with what communities in the ground are feeling like are the best ways to do water exchanges for the well-being of everybody.
Thank you so much. As a final question, I'd like to ask, what are some pitfalls or areas of caution that you would highlight for water managers looking to support community-based water sharing?
I think there's two main areas. So for example, one is the high reliance on community self-management, and the other one is stressing on social networks. So although self-management and social networks are very valuable for residents in order to address water insecurity, we don't want to abuse and create a double burden because in events like hurricanes or earthquakes, people have other needs that they want to attend. So we want to be able to collaborate at various levels so that water needs specifically that are so important in many areas can be met in a way that the residents have the opportunity to address other issues like housing, energy, food, and other areas.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate you sharing your expertise as a shelter administrator and a researcher with us today.
Thank you for having me.